Well, let's move on. And legal and compliance issues have become core to startup operations in India. But what can entrepreneurs do to be on the right side, especially during due diligence and negligence for acquisitions? My colleague Rahul Dayama caught up with Rajiv Khaitan and Ganesh Prasad, partners at Khaitan and Company, for a conversation. And interestingly, Khaitan and Company were the advisors on the Walmart Flipkart deal, which was one of the biggest M&A deals in the space. Let's listen in to that interesting conversation.
What we see here is a lot more sophistication in terms of products, and it's also possibly a reflection on India's growth story. Mm-hmm. And I guess we have had to sort of catch up with the times in terms of not only sort of being able to service this explosion of growth, and also at the same time keeping in line with the needs of sophisticated businesses.
Sir, I'll come to you. Company startups, so to say, about getting corporate governance right.
There's a perceptible change in that, because as they have learnt over experience by understanding from what has happened in the previous transactions, the diligence that any acquirer does is largely also on the corporate and the governance side, and therefore a lot more record keeping, a lot of regulatory compliance is now being adhered to by startups. This trend is going to only increase. And this change is not only happening in the startup space, but even in the companies which acquire funds, which fund them.
Would you agree that this would sort of have a ripple effect? You know, where do you see this going? Over the last 2 years only, we have seen some big exits, for investors. Is that signaling that, we'll see a lot more consolidation on the ground as we really move ahead into 2018?
Yeah, I think consolidation is the name of this game. What we also see is that as India's story is projected to sort of go into trillions of dollars, or possibly in the next 5 years, you will see a lot of new age companies emerge and a lot of value being created. At the same time, consolidation is going to be the mantra for the ecosystem.
When you sort of engage with investors, foreign companies that are sort of looking at acquisition, what's the complaint that you offered here about India, has it become a lot more easier for them to operate?
Some of the sophisticated investors do believe that the record keeping and the type of information that is made available to them is not as much as they would want to. But over the years, Indian startups have also been mentored by people who have done it in the past. Organizations like iSpirit have really helped them understand the requirements for a consolidation between two startups, by a takeover, by a larger player. So learning has improved a lot in the last few years.
In particular, when we talk about startups and these tech companies, what are these big trends that will stand out as we really go ahead?
So I think one trend which possibly will be very important as we progress would be ethics and compliance. Because I guess globally, most companies have zero tolerance for any violation towards ethics and compliance. And I guess rightly so, that's the only way you can sort of get the culture right in a changing world. And in addition to that, I guess we also will look at spending patterns of supply and demand. As supply and demand changes, you will possibly look at a lot more complexity coming with technology.
What is that one or two tips or advice that you'd want to give them to be on the right side? I'll come to you in terms of what advice you would give them to have these big exits and ensure they're on the right side of the deal. But quickly, two tips from you.
Believe in yourself. I think most startups, after reaching a particular stage, start wondering whether they are doing the right thing. And at that stage, a help from people who have done it in the past really helps them continue in their belief and ramping up what they are doing. They've grown from stage A to B by what they have done, but for going from stage B to the next stage, some different skills are necessary. And at times, these startups don't engage or bring on with them people who have experience to go to the next level.
What should they be doing for big companies like Walmart to keep an eye on them? And you know, what should they do to get such instances right?
Or be prepared for them?
See, I don't think there's any one size fits all. But I guess value creation and ethics, I guess so long as you're able to sort of look at ethics, compliance and value creation for the end consumer and also for all stakeholders, I guess people will be afloat. And I guess that is the long-term plan for anybody who is entering this market.
All right, that's an interesting conversation there. But that's all the time we have right here on Startup Central. Thanks so much for watching.